In today's newspaper, that is 13th of October 2017, this news awarding disaster attracts my attention. Invest in efforts to adapt to climate change even while reducing disaster risk. Again, I am reading it. Invest in efforts to adapt to climate change even while reducing disaster risk. You might understand that this is related to the climate change as well as related to the disaster management. The two aspects are there in this, so I am choosing it from the civil services perspective. My dear students, you might have gone through the chapter, the video 504 of our ecology and environment section, chapter 5, video, safe class, smart audio video education class, fourth number, in which I have discussed about the UNFCCC, that is United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. On this, a write-up has been also written by all of you, and I am very sure that you are having some of the concepts related to COP21. That is the 2015 Paris Agreement that we all have a vote that we will make the temperature below 2 degrees centigrade. There are 197 countries of the UNFCCC. It is a international treaty in which has got the wide applicability all over the world. So this aspect is clear to you. After that, I am linking this news with this class of the 504 of our SAVE class from the ecology and environment. We have seen that from this class last year, the questions has also been asked. The questions were related to UNFCCC also, and the question was also regarding to the short-lived carbon pollutants. In that class, I have discussed about that thing, and I had also discussed about that United Nations conventions to combat desertifications, UNCCD, in which I have discussed the concept of the sustainable development and the good governance concept. So this is also an important topic. So from the civil services perspective, I am finding that this is a quite important chapter from which every year I am expecting at least one question. Let us come to this topic, averting disaster. This article has been written by the three luminaries from the three different fields. One is the Achim Stirner, who is administrator of the United Nations Development Project. Petrica Espiona is the Executive Secretary of the United Nations Climate Change. And Robert Glasser is the United Nations Secretary General's Special Representative for Disaster Risk Reduction. So this is a very important article which starts that in recent times, category 5 hurricanes which has come in the Caribbean island, in the Caribbean and the American mainlands also it has come. Then we have also seen regarding the record floods across India, Nepal, in the adjoining areas of the Nepal, that is in the Bihar area, Bangladesh. The drought emergencies are also in the 20 countries in Africa. They have damaged all these regions, killed hundreds, ruined the lives of millions. For those countries that are least development, the impact of disasters can strip away the livelihood. Strip away the livelihood. Means it is very important, which disasters are always anti-poor, no? Livelihoods. So the poor are the sufferers. The impact of disasters can strip away the livelihoods. For developed and the middle income countries, the economic losses from the infrastructure alone can be massive. So why this type of the disasters are there? The author is asking. The three authors have also mentioned that while 4.2 million people dying prematurely, 4.2 million all over the world, 4.2 million people are dying prematurely only due to the ambient pollutions. The effect of this greenhouse gases, whenever I'm talking about UNFCCC, you should have the idea about the greenhouse gases. The greenhouse gases on extreme weather events is coming into sharper focus. So it could not be otherwise when impact of the weather events are so profound. There's much more climate change. During the last 2 years, over 40 million people, mainly in countries which contribute least to global warming, have been forced from their homes by disasters. So these people have to leave their homes. This is clear consensus. Means that what are the problems? The rising temperature. Rising temperature. This is our concern. And we are also finding that with the rising temperature, increase in the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. Means water, rising temperature means water vapor will be more in the atmosphere. Okay? This is one important aspect. And leading to more intense rainfall, flooding in some places, drought in others. So these all things. And we have also seen that there was a satellite which has been launched 25 years back. The name of the satellite was TOPEX. T-O-P-E-X. My dear students, just have a small note. TOPEX. Or its name was Poseidon. TOPEX or Poseidon, about which the author is telling that the first satellite which can measure precisely the sea level rise. It was launched 25 years ago. So this measurement has shown that there is a 3.4 millimeter rise in the sea level every year. And since 25 years, almost 85 millimeter sea level has erosion. So rising and warming of the seas are contributing to the intensity of the tropical storms worldwide. So this type of the category 5 hurricanes and the flooding and all those things that can be linked with this one also, that there is sea level rise also. So my dear students, we have to link all these aspects and we will find that how much is the importance of the UNFCCC at present. So now we let us understand regarding the Paris Agreement, in which we have told that in the COP21 we have told that the temperature, the worldwide temperature, will be pre-industrial era age, that is the almost 2 degree centigrade. So while the Paris Agreement has set the world a long-term path towards a low carbon future, it is a windy path. Thus, we can expect that the carbon emissions will drop as the countries will meet their target. The impact of climate change may be felt for some time, but we have understood one more concept, that is the world overshoot day. Overshoot day. Overshoot day, we have seen that how much is the energy that is being produced by the planet, in how much time it is being utilized. So this is the whole year output, and in which way the world is utilizing. From that aspect, overshoot day had become important. You have made a write-up on it. If not, please make a write-up. So we require international cooperation. We require a restoring the ecological balance between emissions and the natural absorptive capacity of the planet in the long term. So considering all those things, then in the November, in the next month, the UN Climate Conference will be at the Bonn. And this will provide an opportunity of not only accelerate emission reduction, but also to the boost the work for ensuring that the management of climate risk is integrated into disaster risk management as a whole. This is the overall approach of the authors. Now let us try to understand one more article which is related on the same aspects, that is related to the Bonn. What are the things are in the pipeline? In this context, the article on The Hindu on October 10, that is also very important, where the Sujata Baravan, she writes that at Bonn stage the course. She is asking about the renegotiation of the Paris Agreement on climate change is not a viable option. Why renegotiation and is not a viable option? Because for two counts she is asking that, yes, United States of America, USA has pulled out from the Paris Agreement. But still, we cannot have the total agreement with the viewpoint given by the author. Reason is that the other part of the world, other countries, they are much more determined to follow the targets. Moreover, in the new this one, he herself is telling that new, in the new order, they will try to do it up to the level of 1.5 degree centigrade. So this is a very good gesture. So anyhow, we should go through the news and we will find out what are the important salient points. He is telling that between November 6th and 17th this year, world leaders, delegates from various countries and delegates and all those, they will attend the COP Conference of Parties. COP stands for Conference of Parties. My dear students, please write it down. Of the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC, at Bonn. Bonn is where? Bonn is in Germany. No, it is a historical town of the Germany. On the Rhine River, Rhine, we have seen in the world geography. So this there on the number 4, it become legally binding, about which they are telling. What happens that in the COP23, about which the author is telling, they will discuss about the follow-up of the Paris Agreement. Paris Agreement, in short, known as the PA, no? PA, COP21, Conference of Parties 21, 21 meeting. Now, then 23rd meeting at the Bonn, and they will also discuss about the Kyoto Protocol. What are the viewpoints of the Kyoto Protocol? So you require to write down the Kyoto Protocol. What are the important points? This is very important from the civil services perspective. The author is telling that there will be much more discussion at Bonn and the COP23. What are the important points? This will be chaired by, presided by Frank Bainimarama. Frank, do you know he is the Prime Minister of Fiji? Frank Bainimarama. He is the Prime Minister of Fiji. Fiji is one of those countries which, if there will be a rise in the sea level, then this country will submerge. Here much more disaster is going to come. That's why I have linked both the things. And it is fitting that a Pacific island nation chairs the year's conference of parties at the very existence of low-lying islands of Fiji is threatened by the sea level rise due to climate change. The meeting at Bonn will cover a wide range of issues. What are the issues? Including adjusting to living in a warmer world with the associated impacts. Means it has been studied that if the things will be left as such, then the world will be 4.5 degree centigrade warmer still in the next decades. Means the rate of warming has become more than the last decade. But unless no concerted efforts, deliberate efforts are made by the countries, it cannot go to the level of 1.5 degree centigrade. So we have to adjust with all these things. Adaptation to the climate change, reduction in greenhouse gases, these all things are known by the word mitigation. In disaster management, the mitigation word is very important. So mitigation effect of for the climate change, these are the three aspects that we are adjusting as per the environmental impact assessment. For the global rise in the temperature, we are adjusting with the warmer world. We are adaptation to the climate change, reduction in the greenhouse gases. They all will include, this session at the Bonn in COP23, everything will be decided, and they will also decide for the NDC. What is NDC? Nationally determined contributions. Nationally means every world, every nation, nationally determined contribution. Means all members of this 197 members are there, the UNFCCC, they all will decide that how much contribution they are making. So they will in the contribution in the field of the finance, but you just see USA has pulled out. So finance part is a little bit in doldrum. Capacity building, technology transfer. So in this context, please also refer our the classes in the 402 of the SAVE video class, where I have discussed about the carbon trading. This is very important aspect related to the UNFCCC also, or the mitigation effects also. So according to the procedures of the UNFCCC, as I have told, that the conference of the parties, they will discuss about the Kyoto Protocol. They will also discuss about the Paris Agreement. There will be different ad hoc groups also. So all these things they will be there. They will discuss about the modus operandi, how to reduce the global warming. The most important aspect is that the warming target is being set. Warming target, as I have told you, warming target. Earlier, the Lakshman Rekha, the author is telling, was 2 degrees centigrade. At the Paris COP, countries agreed to try and limit the global warming. And they have agreed in the PA that yes, it should be 1.5 degree centigrade. But since previous discussion had centered on the Lakshman Rekha of 2 degree centigrade, this requires the renewed understanding of the policies and actions required to stay within a lower targets. In this context, the Intergovernment Panel on Climate Change, Intergovernment Panel on Climate Change, this is important, and you can expect that the UPSC may ask that IPCC is related with which organizations? UNFCCC. It is related with greenhouse gas reductions. It is relations with global warming. So these aspects, IPCC, Inter Panel Cli on Climate Change. UPSC may critically questions this type of this type of the questions to you. They will pose much more challenge to you. So please be prepared for that, at least in the ecology and environment. So there is an intergovernmental panel on climate change. They will undertake the task. They will make a special report on the impacts of the warming of 1.5 degree centigrade above pre-industrial level and the global response needed to achieve this. So this many scientists who research climate change, however, believe that we are in our way to a world that is 4 degree centigrade warmer, and that limiting warming to less than 1.5 degree centigrade is a pipe dream. So these aspects we have to understand that yes, anyhow the target has to be set and they have to materialize this. The author is talking about the viewpoint of one of the scientists and consider that CO2 and methane. What is the source of the methane? Methane means like the cow dung. That is a big source of the methane. The cow, etc., the ruminant animals. When they ruminate, then they exit out methane also from their mouth. So the methane gas. So these are the decomposition of the carbonaceous or the organic materials that give rise to the methane. So the James Hansen, a distinguished climate scientist, the author is writing, writes in his blog that carbon dioxide and methane are increasing faster than a decade ago, and that efforts being made now at global and state levels are half measures. These are not suitable enough. So we have to devise the ways for these things, the CO2 and the methane, etc. So my dear sir, the UNFCCC is very much clear to you, and we have also seen about the role of the UNFCCC in this greenhouse gas reductions, COP21, COP23. So I think that you are in a better position to understand this type of the international treaty organization, that is the UNFCCC. So I will also look forward for some news related to the climate change, because I understand that climate change is very important topic for the civil services PT examination as well as for the main examination. Thank you.